Okay, in this second video, I want to talk about some simple functions in Excel. Excel comes in preloaded with a large number of formulas or functions that you can use to make all kinds of calculation. You can see them listed as drop-down menus on the Formulas menu. You can see all of these different types of formulas for financial purposes, math, tax, date and time, and so on. Some of the most common functions you might be interested in are listed here on the slide. There's a function to take a square root of a number, to raise a number to a certain power, and then several statistical functions that we'll discuss in a second. For this exercise, we want to calculate three different statistical quantities. These are the mean, which is also called the arithmetic average, the median, and then the standard deviation. In lecture, I would talk about all three quantities, and also in your lab procedure, these are defined. The data set you'll be working with is the third one, which is the exam score data set. So in here, you can see the scores after exam 1 in Chem 11 some years ago for a series of students who were taking the class at the time. So what I want to do is first just calculate an average of all these scores. And I'm going to do it on this cell right here. How do I do that? Well, to do this, you need to know what the name of the function that would allow you to calculate an average. In Excel, this function is called average. So you would type equal and then the word average, and you can see that it's highlighting here several different averages that you can calculate that Excel allows you to do. We want to just do the simple average, put parentheses, and inside the parentheses, I want to calculate the average of all of these numbers. Instead of typing them all in, you can just go inside the parentheses and then highlight all these numbers. You can see what Excel shows here is A3 colon A2, and what that means is it's going to calculate the average for the numbers between cell A3 to cell A20 and all the numbers in between. If you press enter, you get an average value, 68.5. I want you to do the same thing for the median and the standard deviation. These are, again, formulas that you can access from the slide I showed you earlier, or you can also search in Excel to find what the formula is or the function is for standard deviation and for median. Okay, so the last part of this video will discuss how to add data to find intersecting data points. For this exercise, you want to use the last data set that you have from that downloaded file on the website, and this is called the unemployment data set. Now, unemployment, like some other data you collect in physical sciences, it tends to go in a cycle. Some years we have bad years, we call recession years, where unemployment keeps going up. And some years we call them growth years or good years, where unemployment keeps dropping. So what we want to know in this particular data set is at which point during the period from 1989 to the year 2000, is unemployment the highest? At which point during those years? At which specific intervening years? You can determine this by plotting both of these data sets and finding the intersection point between the two data sets. Let me show you what I mean. Okay, so first off, you have to enter data in these form. So you have one data set for the recession years, you have another data set for the growth years, and you're entering them as year, which is one, and then percent unemployment for the Y value, and then the same thing for the growth years. What I want you to do now is generate a linear fit for the first data set. This is something you learn in the beginning part of this video, so I hope you'll be able to do it at this point. And I also want you to generate a line equation and an R-square value for that fit. Okay, if you did that correctly, this graph at the bottom should be what you see. Okay? Now, what I want is to add the second data set now. And the second data set is this one right here. I want to add that to the plot. How do I do that? Okay, what you have to do now is the following. You're going to click inside this plot, doesn't matter where it is, okay? And then right click, and in one of the options you should see select data. Choose that option, and now you should see this window showing up. You want to add, and now what you have to do is add what you want to be the second data set, X values and Y values. How do you do this? You go back to your data set, and for the X values, you want to highlight the years from 1993 to 2000. That's your X values for the second data set. And then for the Y value, you want to do the same thing, but since there's some things already entered here, I'm just going to clear that out, delete it. And then instead, I'm going to highlight the values for the percent unemployment for those years. And then click OK. Now, if you do this, and you click OK for the second time, if I bring that plot back in, you should now see this plot right here, the red one, which corresponds to that second data set that you've added in. So what you want to do is then generate the same fit for the second data set. So you go trend line, and then you can display equation and R-squared. And now what you see is you see the second line having a best fit equation as well as R-squared. And what you can see is that the unemployment is highest during these 2 years, which is 1992 to 1993. So there's a high point here. And if I were to cross these two lines together, I'm going to find a number that corresponds to the highest percent unemployment. Okay? And you can find that number by using the two equations that you have here, because you can simultaneously solve for that intersection point. Okay. So this ends the Excel graphing video. All the skills you learn in these two videos and the first video, which gives you the introduction to graphing, should be very useful in completing your Excel lab assignment.